I recently reviewed this budget turntable I thought gave good value for money. Now at the end of that video I went off in a bit of a rant about another turntable mechanism that you can see in a lot of budget record players, ones that will cost the same amount as this, but it will give a much lower level of performance because it's really designed to cost just a few pounds to manufacture. So it's alright if you stick in a 30 quid turntable like a toy, but you can see it in things that cost an awful lot more. So I just wanted to point out what it looked like to tell people just to watch out for it and be careful. Now a lot of people said I should put that as a separate video in its own right, so that's what I've done here. So here's my rant or PSA about a particular turntable mechanism. Okay, now a few of you might remember when I put this kit together, this cardboard box record player, and I was disappointed because the whole turntable mechanism was pre-assembled. And that's because this whole thing is a unit that's used in a lot of different record players. So it's very easy just to build anything around this. But the problem is that this unit here, it's rubbish. It's garbage. Now, I bought one separately to show you from China. Now, this cost, I think it was about £10 to deliver to the UK. The vast majority of that cost was the postage and packing. The thing itself probably costs about the same as a coffee in Starbucks. And yet a lot of record players are built around this cheap, nasty mechanism. And if you indeed search on Amazon for record player, the first perhaps three pages of your results, almost all of those things, all the sponsored ones and all the companies that have used names that have died years ago, they've badged it on their stuff, it's all this mechanism from China, this horrible piece of rubbish. Now don't get me wrong, I mean, if your smartphone more likely than not has been made in China, and it's decent quality, isn't it? But they can also make rubbish, and these things in my opinion are rubbish. Now some people say, oh, they're not that bad, but it annoys me the fact that you can buy like a record player, it's like £100 and it has one of these things in it. And of course this is the record player. This, everything else that goes around it is just a box and some speakers and things. And people sometimes will send me a link and say, hey Matt, you should review one of these. And I'll click on it and it'll have one of these things in it. And I think, doesn't everyone know what these are and how cheap they are? And I don't know if they do. I mean, I find them really easy to identify. I mean, just look at that. If you see that in the top of something, I would suggest running a mile away from it, not towards it. This arm here, always this same arm with this same red cartridge on it, dead straight piece of metal, always with this little plasticky thing that faces the wrong way, so it's difficult to pick up your arm. I mean, it is really just rubbish. Now, I remember record players that my sister had and stuff back in the 1960s. You bought your singles on 45s and you had your little cheap record player and everyone was quite happy. But nowadays, I think the market has kind of shifted. You know, the whole thing's supposed to be that vinyls is super duper quality and stuff. And people get their records and they'll spend like £20, £30, whatever, for a record. And they get and they're being very careful with it. And then they go and put it on one of these flipping things. I mean, it's ridiculous. The record that they bought is worth more than the record player that they're playing it on. So yeah, if I just want to get one bit of information across, this is a toy. There's no adjustable tracking force on here. I mean, there might be some weird screw or something, but there's no weight on the back. There's no ability to adjust the anti-skating. I can imagine all these people who get hold of these record players. They're quite excited about, oh, I've got a record player, and they get one of these things in it. And they're probably going to be pretty disappointed in it. Go, I don't know what all the fuss is about with record players. It's because of this thing. Go and spend a little bit more money. I mean, try and save up a bit, especially if records themselves are costing like 20 odd quid a piece. But if you're really on a budget, I'd suggest your budget has to reach to about this level to get something that you're going to be happy with. Spend less than this and you're probably going to be disappointed. So that is it for the moment. As always, thanks for watching.